grateful to Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji and also Home Minister Amit Shah ji and All India President Nadda ji.
जो भी पार्टी के केंद्रीय पार्लियामेंट्री जो बोर्ड है हमारा, उसका जो भी फैसला होगा उसके निर्देश पे विधायक दल की बैठक में ही नेता का नाम का चयन होगा.
When he was asked to step down, it shows that there was no good administration here. That will final. The Delhi High Command, what will take, will follow the leader.
Everyone, you're watching News Epicenter with me, Maria Shakil. It is the end of the B.S. Yedurappa era in Karnataka. In a major political churn, the four-time chief minister failed to complete yet another complete term as he submitted his resignation to the governor yesterday. Union ministers Dharmendra Pradhan and G. Kishan Reddy are in Bengaluru as central observers, as all eyes are on the crucial BJP legislature party meeting, which has begun, where B.S. Yedurappa's successor will be selected and announced. Though several names are doing the rounds, two names have emerged as front runners in this race. Basavaraj Bommai, who is a close confidant of B.S. Yedurappa, and Murugesh Nirani, who is businessman, politician, also belonging to the powerful Lingayat community. The big question remains if a Lingayat leader will be chosen as the next chief minister, or if a fresh face will emerge on the top. The Lingayats, remember, make up for nearly 17% of the state's population and can determine the poll outcome in 90 to 100 constituencies. Or will the BJP ignore this influential constituency and come up with a formula similar to the experiments in states such as Haryana, Jharkhand and Maharashtra? While there are many reasons being given for the exit of B.S. Yedurappa, one factor could be the age of the caretaker chief minister. He was the oldest chief minister among all the incumbent BJP chief ministers, and with his resignation, the BJP now has the chance to bring in a younger face, keeping in mind the crucial 2023 assembly polls. With the BJP's general in South retiring from battle, a crown of thorns quite literally awaits his successor. In its balancing act, the party has to now crack the age plus caste code in the hunt for Yedurappa's replacement. Let me go straight to Capitol Hotel in Bengaluru, where the legislature party meet of the BJP is going to begin any moment now. Deepa Balakrishnan is joining me live from there. Deepa, the big question is, who is B.S. Yedurappa's successor? Of course, we'll know about it in just a few minutes. But did the central observers hold separate meetings with any of the legislatures, or are you getting the sense that it is only a matter of communication, that all of them will be told that here is the leader that the party central leadership wants and they have to go ahead and endorse him?
Batches of MLAs who have gone and met with the central team that has come in. First of all, Arun Singh and Nalin Kumar Kadhi. You're seeing, of course, a stream of MLAs have been coming in constantly over the last half an hour or so. We've already seen some of the top people like, the former ex-deputy chief minister Ashwath Narayan, Umesh Kathi, one of the senior most MLAs. All these have already gone, and some of the MLAs from who have come in, who have defected from the Congress and the JDS to the BJP just 2 years back, have also come in. Now, a batch of them, the defectors, had actually gone and met with the central team that came in and held their own parleys. Perhaps they were trying to remind the central high command that, there was a commitment that all of them would be made ministers, or a majority of them would be made ministers and accommodated in the Council of Ministries. So perhaps that was the intention there. There have also been other ministers and prominent, other former ministers and prominent MLAs who've been going in ones and twos and meeting them at different places. One of them is K.S. Ishwarappa, who's the rural development minister in the government until yesterday, of course. He met with Arun Singh and Nalin Kumar Kattil at the BJP office. There were a few others like Arvind Billat, who also went in and met with the party high command at the KK guest house where they were staying for a short while. So many of these central, in fact, all of them from the central team have gone and met caretaker Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa and spoken to him before they came in for this legislature party meeting that is about to begin in just a minute, in just minutes from now. And so yes, they seem to have made that, you know, effort to ensure that their meeting with B.S. Yediyurappa has been taken note of, that they are going to be taking him into confidence before they make any announcement of any sort. Another point that we asked Arun Singh about, will there be a proper official announcement today or will there just be a decision today which will still be kept under wraps until the party high command approves it? He only said wait for some time, we'll know at the end of the meeting. So we are of course waiting with bated breath. Perhaps a half an hour to 1 hour from now we will know the answer to those questions.
Yes, so the big question is, will we know who is the successor of B.S. Yediyurappa in just a few minutes, because the legislature party meeting has begun and Deepa Balakrishnan is joining us from there. Let me bring in my guests at this hour. Vasanthi Hari Prakash is a senior journalist. She joins me live. Dhanya Rajendran, editor-in-chief of the News Minute. Suraj Hegre is the spokesperson of the Congress party. Captain Ganesh Karnik is the chief spokesperson of the BJP Karnataka. Dhanya, Basavraj Bommai has emerged as the front runner. What do you think could make him acceptable?
Well, first thing, bringing Basavraj Bommai definitely means that the BJP wants to play it safe as far as the caste equations go. They replace a Lingayat chief minister with another Lingayat leader. And of course, Basavraj Bommai is someone who's been a minister many times. He's a home minister of the state. He is close to B.S. Yediyurappa. So maybe even Yediyurappa, what we are hearing is that Yediyurappa would be okay with Bommai's name. In fact, Yediyurappa would be happy if Bommai is made the next chief minister. So that would be the BJP playing safe. I mean, bringing any Lingayat leader to replace B.S. Yediyurappa, I would say, is the BJP preferring to play safe. If they do not want to do that, and if they want to go beyond the caste factor, the caste equation, then the party would try to bring in someone else, a non-Lingayat leader, perhaps from Vakkaliga or a Brahmin or even a Dalit chief minister, and then try to consolidate other castes in using various other ways, including appointing different deputy chief ministers.
And we have seen that, Vasanthi, you know, the political domination of the BJP in 2014 onwards gave the party enough leeway to experiment with leadership, you know. So in Maharashtra, for example, it nominated Devendra Fadnavis, a Brahmin, as the chief minister. In Haryana, Manohar Lal Khattar was the party's choice for the chief minister's post. And in Jharkhand, which is a tribal state, Raghubar Das was asked to lead the government.
Maria, the guessing game is still going on. BJP does have this, let's say, tendency to pick up a nobody sometimes. When I say nobody, it's not a political nobody, but it means that it's an unexpected dark horse and given the top post, because it wants to send a message that the party is far more important than the individual. They have had some, wisdom gained from experiences of letting one person becoming a community stronghold man, just like how they have had with Mr. Yediyurappa as a Lingayat leader. But, it's almost like it's no one's... I mean, the jury is still out. I think a few minutes before, I made a phone call to Brahmadev, the creator, saying who's going to be Karnataka's chief minister. And he said that I have sent two people from Gujarat to Delhi and only they alone know. I think the die has been cast, but there's just endless.
And you know, Vasanthi, so that has been communicated, I think, to these two gentlemen who are on our television screens, Dharmendra Pradhan and Kishan Reddy, who are union ministers and who have gone to Karnataka for overseeing the entire process of transition. Yes, yes.
There are some names that have, for instance, come up, like, for instance, Arvind Ballard. Young person, engineer, educated abroad, and the son of veteran RSS leader, Chandrakant Ballard, has got some of these right qualifications, but he's an MLA. He's not really held any cabinet portfolio. So while you're balancing the thing of age, the caste, the capability, I mean, there are many, many factors to consider here, but really, I don't think anybody is in the know. And that's exactly what has been the mood, even among party karyakartas, that no one knows, and that's what everyone knows.
Yes, that is the BJP style of functioning, where they believe in a lot of surprises. Those are visuals coming in live from Bengaluru, where the legislature party meeting is going to begin any moment now. The central observers reached Bengaluru a couple of hours ago, and they will be overseeing this entire process. Remember, B.S. Yeddurappa, after that tearful exit in which he resigned while addressing a press conference, went straight to the governor's residence to submit his resignation. The governor, Thavarchand Gehlot, was earlier in the national capital. He had rushed to Bengaluru to accept the chief minister's resignation. He was asked to continue as the caretaker chief minister, and now this entire power transition happening there. Let me bring Suraj Hegde here. Suraj, you know, you may say that this is, of course, an internal matter of the BJP, and this is rightly so, because, you know, when whatever plays out in Punjab, they say that it's an internal matter of the Congress party. Or, for example, even in Rajasthan, they have left it on the Congress leadership to decide who will be the chief minister. Then why is Congress fishing in troubled waters?
In what way are we fishing in troubled waters? Basically, BJP destabilized the coalition government, took away 17 people, actually blackmailed them, took them to Maharashtra, put them in a hotel in Bombay. You know, they formed a government based on that. These are the hard facts and realities I'm talking to you, which the whole country has watched. So after forming the government, today, what is the reason for Mr. Yeddurappa's replacement? Has he been corrupt? Is it because of old age? Is it because of ill health? Is it because of his inability to administer? What is it? There is no reason that they're given. Then they talk about age is the factor that he's been removed. Chief Minister of Kerala, if you can please let me know and enlighten. Then the candidate for the Chief Minister of Kerala, Sridharan's age is what age?
Okay.
He's 89 years.
Okay, Captain Ganesh.
Criteria is according to whims and
yes.
fancies.
You know, this is not just the Congress party which is asking this question, Captain Ganesh. Even political analysts want to know what exactly is the reason for the exit of B.S. Yeddurappa. Or is it age alone, as some analysts would want to believe, although the party has not given any reason so far? Captain Ganesh, if you can hear me. We seem to have lost that line with Captain Ganesh. We'll try and connect with him again. Sanjay, go ahead. Yes. Sanjay, if you can hear me.
I'm Suraj, madam.
Yes. Suraj, the question that I wish to ask is that we are seeing those visuals, and of course, if the indications are so far that they could very well be going for a Lingayat chief minister, a successor for B.S. Yeddurappa, the fact is that this is a dominant caste. But this dominant caste has not always had its affiliation only with the BJP. They have shown their affiliation and support for the Congress also in the past.
It's true. We have also had many Lingayat chief ministers. Even their party has been, earlier B.B. Shivappaji is also a tall Lingayat leader, which they have forgotten. I'm reiterating the same thing, because they keep forgetting their seniors and they keep sending them to Margarshan Mandals, which, you know, is like nobody knows what happens there. That is their party's internal issue, whatever they want to have, they can have it. But what I'm trying to tell you is, why this sort of an instability when we are facing heavy floods? None of the bureaucrats are working right now. Is it required to have this event and tamasha? Who's going to be the next chief minister of Karnataka for 2 years? I just want to ask you one hypothetical question. What if there is not going to be one after announcing the chief minister's name? What if there's going to be instability?
Okay. Captain Ganesh,
who's going to be
at this point, how right is it for the central leadership of the BJP to push the state of Karnataka in this kind of uncertainty and political instability?
Yeah, basically what I'm trying to tell you is this sort of streak of dictatorship is what I'm being...
Okay, Captain Ganesh.
Visible.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Who's taking the call?
Yeah, see, you played a video clip as the program started, Maria. And in that video clip, Honorable Chief Minister voluntarily stepped down. That is the statement he made. Now tell me, whatever has happened during the past 2 years since he took over as the Chief Minister, and whatever has transpired between the central leadership as well as the chief minister, and what transpired in the last visit he made to Delhi. And subsequently, on completion of the second year, he has voluntarily stepped down. And he has assured the party leadership that he'll become a disciplined soldier of the party. He will tour the entire state and his only mission will be to bring back
party to power in the next election. But Captain Ganesh, this is not what exactly the chief minister said last week. Last week, he gave the impression, yes, and this was on record, when he said that he is waiting for a, you know, instruction to come from the party high command, from the central leadership, that is likely to come on 25th. And if they ask me to continue as the chief minister, I will. If they ask me to go, then I will do so as well. Those are the words of B.S. Yeddurappa as well. How do we forget that while you're talking about this voluntary exit?
If you permit me to answer, I will permit. I don't have the habit of interjecting in between. I'm sorry to say this. Yesterday, he made it very clear, I have not received any instruction from the central leadership. And that is why he said he's stepping down on his own. Possibly that was the agreement which happened 2 years ago. So if you want me to go back 1 week ago, I will stick on to what he said yesterday. That is one part. So party has the onerous responsibility of electing the new legislative party leader. So the central leadership has sent two observers, and 7 o'clock the party legislative party meeting is on, and very soon you will get the results of it.
Okay, but now, do we know why is he going? Why was B.S. Yeddurappa asked to go, or why did he voluntarily exit?
I quote his own statement yesterday. He said, I am stepping down on my own. I am thanking the party leadership for having considered me to continue in the seat for more than 2 years after completing 75 years. He profusely thanked the central leadership. Now, if you
this
ask me why,
sir,
I don't have any
your
answer.
Your chief minister candidate of Kerala is announced who's 89 years old, sir. How can you just come and tell, you know, whichever age factor, all of a sudden? And the day he took charge as chief minister, you are 75 years. Above 75 years.
Mr. Suraj, please, I'm not here to answer these questions raised by you. This is your perspective, I appreciate.
This is the reality I'm putting in front of you, sir.
Party has taken a decision to not permit anyone to take any post after 75 years. But Mr. Yeddurappa was brought in as a chief minister after he completed 25 years.
Yes.
So party at a certain point of time, keeping in view various facts and figures, possibly has taken a decision.
Let me go back.
How anybody can question that?
Let me go back to the two analysts.
Why did you bring in Sridharan and why did you promise him to be...
Okay, let me go back to the analysts.
Even at age of 89. Hmm.
You can't tell the people anything that comes into mind and get away.
I'm like a gentleman. I will not ask such questions.
Okay.
Party at its own...
Age factor, then please don't bring the criteria, sir. Age is not a criteria then.
And
okay, let me go back. Let me go back to the analysts and discuss the successor, because all eyes are clearly on who will be, you know, really carrying forward the legacy of B.S. Yeddurappa in many ways. How difficult, Dhanya, do you think it will be for anybody to step into those shoes? Because, you know, he was clearly the face of the BJP in Karnataka, and that is the only fort or the bastion of the BJP.
Well, Maria, there are two things here. First, it's not going to be very easy for any leader to step into Yeddurappa's shoes, and remember, elections are just 2 years away. So they have to ensure that they build a base across the state, and that their leadership is able to bring together
Dhanya,
all
just a moment, just look at those visuals. It's very clear that it's B.S. Yeddurappa who's sitting next to the driver, and behind him are the two central observers. So there are enough indications for us to believe that the successor would have his approval as well. So the central leadership might have taken his consent before making that announcement or the entire legislature party meeting. Go ahead, Dhanya.
Well, we are hearing that B.S. Yeddurappa is pushing for Basavaraja Bommai as the next chief minister. So let's see if Bommai does get announced. If that's so, then it seems to be Yeddurappa's wish. Now, even if it's Bommai as the next chief minister, two things are very clear. One is that if the BJP does not want to antagonize BS Yedurappa, wants him to remain
okay,
in the
those,
BJP's
those
fold,
visuals on our television screens, and let's go full frame with it. BS Yedurappa, the man of the moment in many ways, he is now entered along with the two central observers. That is where, that's Capitol Hill in Bengaluru, where the legislature party meeting will be taking place. Remember, he accompanied the two central observers. That is a big political move again. He's accompanied them, sending a message that he is part of the entire process, that B.S. Yedurappa is not sulking, that he is not unhappy with the entire move. He has seen several political transitions. He himself has never completed a full five-year term. So he understands the nuances. He understands the power plays. He understands the treacherous political terrain after having spent several decades at the helm of affairs in many ways in Karnataka. Yes, go ahead, Vasanthi. Now, when we look at those visuals, your thoughts, B.S. Yedurappa arriving there along with the two central observers.
Maria, we have to take one thing into consideration, that an out of power Yedurappa is just as powerful, or I would say even yes, more powerful a presence, because at least as chief minister, he has his own constraints. Whereas out of power, he still, of course, is a very powerful community leader and someone who is the incumbent, someone who is his successor, in a manner cannot afford to displease Mr. Yedurappa himself. But I really want to draw the audience attention to a larger picture of the price that Karnataka is having to pay because of this political uncertainty all the time. Mr. Yedurappa's tenure, even at present, has had absolutely no major schemes announced. The management of the COVID-19 pandemic really leaves much to be desired. We have been witness to a horrific tragedy in Chamrajnagar district near Mysore, the loss of 24 lives because of what many people believe could have been avoided, the loss of those lives, if only there had been proper coordination between bureaucracy and the political leadership. Now, this is what we are facing in Karnataka. But time and again, every time there is a change of helm, BJP or any other ruling party wants to change the top guy in the state. There is absolutely no consideration as to what will happen or what is the janta of Karnataka going through. Files don't move. The work comes to a standstill. It's really not possible for everything to really go on autopilot when there is so much of political turbulence really in the state. And this is something that the BJP also has to consider. Its own image as a working, functioning party. It's not just, you know,
those gestures. As a political journalist, I'm going to highlight certain gestures that I'm witnessing on our television screens, and I think it's very, very important. So B.S. Yedurappa sitting next to the driver on the front row with Dharmendra Pradhan and Kishan Reddy behind him. All of them reach the Capitol Hotel. They step down. There is a scarf of sorts waiting for Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan. He says, let Mr. B.S. Yedurappa step down first. Just look at those visuals. I think those are important political gestures. That sends a message of how the party leadership is viewing the exit of B.S. Yedurappa. He is the man of the moment and he is exiting politics, not really only as the chief minister, saying clearly that he will be continuing as the party karyakarta or the BJP worker here onwards. That remains our top focus here on CNN News 18. In some time from now, we will know who will be the next chief minister of Karnataka. That and much more. Thank you so much for watching.